In today's video, I am going to explain muscle anatomy for stretching. Today's stretching is forward bending. Forward bend stretching. I believe this is the most popular stretching, right? I am going to focus on two parts. First part is backside of lower extremity, and second part is low back, which is back muscles. These two places need to be stretched in order to get enough flexibility for forward bend. Let me explain lower extremity first. This is posterior view of lower extremity. You're looking thigh from behind. I want you to focus on these muscles. Okay, this is muscle group. This one is called hamstrings. Hamstrings. On inside of hamstring, there are two muscles. One thing is semimembranosus. Semimembranosus. And second one is semitendinosus. They are on medial part. How about lateral part? This is biceps femoris. These three muscles together, it is called hamstrings. Then, if you want to understand stretching, you better need to understand muscle function. So what is function of hamstrings? There are two main functions. One thing is hip extension. Hip extension. I will explain joint movement later. One thing is hip extension. Next one is knee flexion. Knee flexion. What is hip extension? Hip extension is you bring leg posterior. Okay, when you stand up, your leg goes posterior. So in this case, her hip is in flexion position. Okay, hip is flexed. Okay, this is flexion position. What is function of hamstrings? That is hip extension. Hip extension is hamstrings contraction. So, this is hip flexion position. It's completely opposite because it is stretching for hamstrings. You need opposite movement, right? Main movement of hamstrings, extension. You need flexion for good hamstrings stretching. That means if your hamstring is too tight, you can bring your hip to flexion. That makes sense, okay? Hip extension is function. If it's too tight, you can't bend hip towards hip flexion. Does it make sense? Then one more function is knee flexion, right? Knee flexion is easy. You bend knee. That's knee flexion. And if you try to go to forward bend stretching, if your hamstring is tight, tendency is your knee goes to bend because hamstring is tight. Function of hamstrings is knee flexion. Yep, knee flexion. Thus, if your hamstring is too tight, you can't keep your knee joint straight because that hamstrings tries to bring your knee joint to flexion because it is tight. So, if you want good length of forward bending position, you need good flexibility of hamstrings. If it's too tight, there's no good length. Okay. Then, since I'm talking about hamstrings, I want to talk about calf muscle, particularly gastrocnemius. Gastrocnemius, that is calf muscle. This person flexes her ankle like this, right? If your toe is facing up, that gives more stretching for gastrocnemius. Why? Because function of gastrocnemius is to pointing out toe. This way movement is completely opposite. Thus, your toes are facing to ceiling, that gives more stretch for gastrocnemius. More interesting thing is your hamstrings and gastrocnemius have myofascial connection. What do I mean myofascial connection? Simply, it's all connected. It's all one continuous structure. Thus, if your hamstrings is too tight, maybe your gastrocnemius is tight. Vice versa, if your gastrocnemius is tight, your hamstrings can be tight. This is not the 100% equation, but this is high tendency. This posterior lower extremity connection is very important. If one of these places gets tight, maybe the other place can be tight. Okay, knowing anatomy is important to enhance proprioception and body awareness. If your body awareness increases, that gives more effect for stretching. Thus, anatomy is very important. This is posterior lower extremity. Let's go to low back. Okay, this is low back. I want you to focus on this area. There are many muscles around low back, particularly erector spinae. Erector spinae and multifidus. They are very famous back muscle. If these guys are tight, it's gonna be problem. You can't go that far away. This person is very flexible. If your low back, of course your hamstring is tight, it's gonna be like this. You can't bend your low back that much. So again, your hamstrings need to get good flexibility and also for low back. But wait a minute, spine, vertebra is all connected. Maybe your thoracic spine can be tight. Maybe your cervical spine can be tight. If these places get tight, that aggravate forward bending position. Yes, that is true. But tendency is low back can be tight most of the time because of, you know, modern lifestyle, right? We use computer a lot. We sit a lot. We, you know, do office work a lot. Thus, your low back takes a lot of mechanical stress. Thus, that can be very tight. So, your low back and hamstrings needs good flexibility. You can say same thing for forward bending position on sitting position. Your hamstrings needs good flexibility and also for low back, right? If your low back is very tight, your trunk is gonna be like this, not much flexion. I have to keep repeating, your hamstrings and low back needs good flexibility. And of course for gastrocnemius, your gastrocnemius needs good length to get, you know, good length on lower extremity. Hamstrings, gastrocnemius, hamstrings, low back muscle is very, very important. And let me explain myofascial connection between hamstrings and low back. I said there is myofascial connection between hamstrings and gastrocnemius, and there's also connection between low back and hamstrings. This is low back. And you see this white structure? This is ligament that connects sacrum and pelvis. This is connective tissue. This is ligament. Low back muscles and sacrum ligament is connected. Okay, you got it? Then, this is the ligament. This ligament and hamstrings has myofascial connection. Again, your hamstrings and gastrocnemius has connection. there's one continuous structure on posterior side. Gastro, hamstrings, ligament. Then, ligament, sacrum, low back, huh? Then again, hamstrings, ligament, low back. You can connect these lines, gastrocnemius, hamstrings, ligament, and low back. If this kind of mechanical chain is tight, you lack flexibility for forward bending, stretching. This area is very, very important. So I explained important muscle anatomies for forward bending, stretching. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.